We were one quarter in when he broke the terrible news to all of the KGA fifth graders. He had been diagnosed with prostate cancer. Having had grandparents that had beat cancer, I know he could beat it. Also, never having met a grandparent because of cancer, I also knew that he was in for the fight of his life. I felt like I had to do something. Everybody knows that there are different colored ribbons to bring awareness to the different types of cancer. What could 4 inches of light blue ribbon really mean to someone? The answer, everything. I've never had a teacher that put so much love into his students than he does his own family. The reason that I felt like I had to do something was because I was afraid my peers wouldn't understand the severity of something like cancer. I had too much experience to know that we couldn't let him do it alone. I brought the idea to my parents. My dad thought I was crazy to make a ribbon for all 111 students. I wasn't going to give in. I started one night, and 3 days later, I had 120 ribbons. The whole time I was making these ribbons, I was thinking, how much could 4 inches of ribbon, 2 simple stitches, and 1 safety pin really mean to somebody? After a few days, my peers wore them less and less, but I knew that these little ribbons meant that he didn't have to fight this alone and that I wasn't going to let him lose. I was just a 10-year-old kid. I worried about sports, my friends, and what horrible thing my mom was going to make for dinner tonight. I didn't think it would mean so much. I guess I was wrong.
She was the first dog adopted at her foster event. So I cried that night. Got quite attached to her. But within a week, we had another dog. It was Kylie, the husky. She was also first adopted at her event. So I got used to the dogs leaving and coming and going, coming and going. And so we didn't really. We actually went to another foster program, and it was Take Me Home Arizona. And they go around, they get calls from people, hey, at our house, we have 5 dogs or whatever, this guy's abusing them. One of my dogs was locked in a room with 2 other dogs, and they're forced to do their business on a bare ground. They had like food slipped under the door, like maybe once a day. So the people in charge of the rescue went and saved them. And I'm trying to save dogs from that happening to them. There's so many things that can happen to any animal in general. There's so many dogs out there wandering the streets, being abused, held in homes, not getting time outside. They're having to hold in their business. And so they get diseases. One of my dogs, Benson, was found out wandering the desert Indian territory, and he was hours away from getting euthanized. He had a skin condition, which he had no fur. So we found him, and he had to have special medicine, special showers, but we took care of him, and he got adopted. And he's living in a home now with another dog, and it just made me so happy to realize that you can do, you can save the dogs. It's all up to you. You can go out there, you can adopt dogs, you can foster them. Anything you do, you can save them. Okay. I fostered 7 dogs now. They're all hours away from being dead. You can go out there and you can save them. It's a hound dog's dream to be adopted. You can just, when you go, you walk by and they're standing there. You don't know what's happened to them. They're up in tears. You can be the one to save them and say, "You're mine." Thank you.
We held a lemonade stand to raise money for the Chandler Education Foundation. We decided that since we wanted to donate money, but didn't just want to take it out of our piggy banks, that we should hold a lemonade stand to work for the money instead. We spent a lot of time planning and creating signs. We had to advertise our lemonade stand to the public and to our classmates. We spent a lot of time buying the things we needed and setting up. It took most of our time that week, but in the end, it was all worth it. In the first hour or so, we had barely any customers. Every once in a while, a person would stop by, but then the second hour was packed. We kind of wished that we had more employees. It all worked out, and it was for a good cause. We managed to make $92.46. It was very fun, and I would definitely do it again. I like working for my money, not just getting it from mom or dad. We made the lemonade, had time left over, so decided to bake some treats to go along as well. We made cookies and brownies. The brownies sold very fast, so did the bigger cookies. The smaller sugar cookies did not sell very well. We think this is because we priced them too high. Our classmates came and supported us for the whole second hour. All 4 of our teachers came, and we were packed, which also helped the strangers want to come over and see what was happening. The second hour was when we made most of our money, and we were very happy. The first hour, we got a lot of honks, but no customers. It was also disappointing when we thought that they were going to stop, but it turned out they just slowed down for the cookie stop. It was rough, but we kept going because we knew that it was for a good cause and didn't want to give up so easily. We had faith in our classmates that they would show up, and they did. Overall, we had a ton of fun, and that is the most important part. This lemonade stand was a huge success, and I would love to do it again. Now we'll just have to wait till next year. Would you like some samples? Donations are always accepted. Thank you.